Your challenge is accepted. Two parameters, though. Number one, if someone in that locker room is so stupid as to be willing to team with you, it has to be someone that wrestled this past weekend at WrestleMania. And now you're gonna realize how alone you are. Because anyone who walks down that aisle and agrees to team with you tonight against Roman Reigns and Solo will never get another title match against Roman Reigns as long as Roman Reigns is the undisputed WWE Universal Heavyweight Champion. So, who you want to talk about now, Cody?
Oh, God.
The Beast Incarnate is here on Monday Night Raw. Is Lesnar here to be Cody's partner?
Lesnar stepping up alongside the American Nightmare.
KP, do you realize what this means? That stipulation doesn't apply to Brock Lesnar. Brock Lesnar is already forbidden from challenging Reigns for the title. Brock lost that right at SummerSlam last year.
And their opponents, first from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 286 pounds, Brock Lesnar! And his tag team partner from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 222 pounds, the American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes!
Wait a second! What the hell? Lesnar just F5'd Rhodes! What the hell are we witnessing here? Another thunderous F5. But why? Why is Lesnar doing this to Cody Rhodes? Cody,
oh, no.
Still battered from last night's main event at WrestleMania.
Bro, no.
We don't need to do this.
Oh, F5 across the announce desk.
Oh, no. No. Oh, my God. Oh, no. The ribs against Cody's got to be suffering serious damage right now in the clutches of the Beast Incarnate.
I'll be as honest as I can possibly be. If the question is posed to me, are you scared of Brock Lesnar? Yes. Yes. I'd be crazy not to be scared of Brock Lesnar. But I still want to fight Brock Lesnar. I'm so scared of Brock Lesnar and what happened to me last week that when he blinks, I'm gonna strike. When he breathes, I'm gonna kick. When he stumbles, I'm gonna pounce. I wanna make sure, leave no stone unturned, no opportunity behind, that when Brock Lesnar looks in the mirror the next time, he doesn't see predator. For the first time in his life, he sees prey. For the first time in his life, he sees a victim, my victim. So it can be anywhere, anytime, any place. But I know Brock Lesnar isn't here in Seattle. So Brock Lesnar, what do you say? Face to face, eye to eye, one on one, the first time ever, the American Nightmare Cody Rhodes versus yourself at WrestleMania Backlash. Answer the call.
Cody, listen to me, please. Listen to me. Do not listen to them. Listen to me, please. Think about this clearly. We don't need this. We certainly do not need this. I need you to leave it. If you're not going to do it on your own, then gentlemen, please come help Cody Rhodes leave the ring tonight. Please.
Questionable of the decision as it is. Adam Pearce is trying to protect
Cody,
Cody
chair
himself.
Down, please. Think about this. Think about this, please. This does not have to happen like this. Cody, listen to me. Don't do this.
The beast incarnate is here.
I know that's what you want, Cody. I know that's what you want, but it can't happen. Like, look at me, please. Look at me. Listen, you want the match with Brock. I know you want the match with Brock. I will give you the match with Brock May 6th in Puerto Rico at Backlash. Brock Lesnar versus Cody Rhodes at Backlash. I make it official right now. Please don't do this. Do it in Puerto Rico. Do it at Backlash. Not tonight.
Lesnar grinning ear to ear. He's ready to take Cody Rhodes for a trip to the train station.
Come on, Cody.
Cody's not thinking straight. I understand Cody's frustrations, but this is gonna cost Rhodes a lot of money.
You said it already, Graves. He's got fire in the eyes, and those eyes are checking out Lesnar.
Cody's frustrated. Cody's blind with rage right now, and Lesnar's enjoying every second of it. Lesnar knows exactly what he's doing right now. Uh-oh! Don't do it, Cody! There's another wave of security keeping Rhodes away from Lesnar.
How does it feel to be looking at the only real cowboy in the state?
Brock, seriously, Brock, we cannot do this tonight. I've asked respectfully. We have business to discuss tonight. Draft business trumps everything. I need you to leave the ring, Brock, please. And if you won't leave, my gentleman will help you leave. With all due respect, please.
With all due respect, it's going to take a hell of a lot more men than that.
Come on, guys.
Good on Adam Pearce for reinforcing our security tonight, but Lesnar doesn't look like he has intentions of going anywhere.
Please, Brock. Please.
Dropped the beast! The American Nightmare just knocked down the beast incarnate before being swarmed by WWE security.
Brock Lesnar, the most decorated.
Well, look at him! Cody Rhodes! Rhodes before the opening bell! Bringing the fight to the beast.
This match isn't even underway, and Cody Rhodes has locked himself into the beast and now using the cowl from our announce table to take out Brock Lesnar.
And before we talk about tonight, let's talk about Backlash. The biggest, most watched Backlash of all time, from the Island of Charm there in Puerto Rico. All the pomp, all the circumstance. I didn't get to experience it that way because I had the daunting task ahead of me of competing against the Beast, the most decorated combat sports athlete. I'm talking about Brock Lesnar. And here is what I discovered. I discovered what Brock Lesnar is made of because it was literally all over my fist. I discovered that Brock Lesnar can be defeated because at Backlash, I beat Brock Lesnar.
Cody's feeling it. Crossroads.
Cody looking for a little insurance.
And a second crossroads.
Will the third time be the charm?
Here we go. Can Cody Rhodes, the American Nightmare, put away the Miz to advance?
What the hell? Brock Lesnar. F5 to Cody Rhodes. And there's no disqualification in a triple threat match. Coup de grâce.
Back inside we go on Finn Balor now. They capitalize and advance.
Here is your winner, Finn Balor.
Good God.
Look at this face.
Look at this face!
What do you want to talk about, Cody? Huh? What do you want to talk about? I want to talk about me. Me, Cody. I want to talk about me. Me! 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 Cody Rhodes! Look at my face! You want to take credit for this, Cody? You lucked into this face. You lucked into the victory Saturday night. I want to talk about a fight. I want to talk about a fight. A fight! I want a fight! You, me, Knight of Champions, or fight. What do you got to say in that? Who is the coward now?
It is Brock Lesnar's nature to hunt. Brock Lesnar must be hunting. But make sure, Brock, if you're the one who's hunting, let me ask you something. How's your face? I know, Brock Lesnar, you look in the mirror, you see a lion, you see the alpha male of our species, but you should also see a black eye, a set of staples, and when I look in the mirror, I see the man who put them there. I see a man who busted Brock Lesnar's face and maybe broke his spirit and beat the biggest bully in WWE history. So I gladly accept Brock Lesnar's challenge at Night of Champions. And I'm not gonna go out of bounds on Brock Lesnar. There's always been this talk about his ego, his manipulation on the roster, his dates. You wanna know why Brock Lesnar is on top and has been on top? Because Brock Lesnar is better than 99.9% of the superstars who come in this ring. But at Backlash, Brock Lesnar was not better than me. He called it a cheap win. Oh, a wrestling counter to a wrestling move in a wrestling ring. How cheap that is. Brock, even if I had been imbued with the powers of a god and beat you in 20 seconds, you still would have hunted me because this isn't about a championship. This is about something else. This is about who is the big thing on Monday Night Raw. The next big thing, that's what they always said about Brock Lesnar. The next big thing, the next big thing, the next big thing. And they were right. But eventually, Brock, what happens when they just say, next? You have conquered WWE, you have conquered sports entertainment, you have conquered this sport, but we are at the point where I need you to take your busted face, I need you to step aside, because you, sir, are not the big thing around here anymore. You are simply in my way.
The American Nightmare, Cody Rhodes, arriving tomorrow.
Step up
to Brock Lesnar.
Listen, I know what you're trying to do. I have a respect for it. I understand.
I know you understand it. But that's a position I'm in, right? I need to get you medical attention, Cody. You need to let the
I don't need any medical attention. I don't need any doctors. I told Adam Pearce already.
Oh, come on, Cody. I can look at that arm right now. Just looking at it, I can tell you that's broken. And I can tell by the look on your face, you know damn well it's broken. Get it, man. No one's questioning how tough you are. I understand you're afraid at this moment.
Afraid? Afraid? Hunter, what do I have at this point to be afraid of?
You are afraid that if a doctor comes in here and looks at that and tells you it's broken, I'm not going to let you go to Night of Champions to face Brock Lesnar.
Man, really? Over this? Over an arm? You subscribe to the same thing I do. My legs are working just fine. My legs work. I walk to the ring. Come on.
Come on, Cody. You don't have to prove anything to anybody here. This is not about how tough you are. It's not. I watched you go to the ring with a torn pec against Seth Rollins inside Hell in the Cell. I've never seen anything like it. I don't question for a second how tough you are. But this is different, right? Think about that year you spent on the shelf after that. A year out of your career, a year out of your life.
I understand, right? And that year, it was terrible. You know what's far worse? What would happen to me if I ended up just being a coward? If I came back to Monday Night Raw, a complete shadow of myself, if I didn't go to Night of Champions and fight? And please, of all people, really? Of all people, let me ask you something. What would you do? What have you done? You fought. That's what I'm going to do. I am going to Night of Champions. I am going to fight Brock Lesnar.
Somebody is arriving right now to the arena. Who could it be? Huh. Oh, I can only imagine the energy backstage right now.
A lot of nerves out there, I would think, though, too. That's a big part of this.
Oh,
he went with the white. Rhodes. Went with the full white suit today, did
He's
Cody.
He's smiling.
Excuse me, Cody. Spilling. I just have two quick questions for you. First off, any update on the condition of your left arm? And do you have any final comments about your opponent tonight, Brock Lesnar? I mean, cat's out of the bag. Last night at the press event, we talked about there's a small fracture. Doesn't change my spirits coming into this thing. I'm in a good mood. I beat Brock Lesnar. I beat him in under 10 minutes last time. And I just changes the strategy, changes the game plan, but doesn't change my mood. I'm excited to be here. As far as last comments for Brock Lesnar, tomorrow I'm going to wake up. His arm is still going to be broken, right? But tomorrow Brock Lesnar is going to wake up, and he is going to be 0-2. I can live with a broken arm. Can Brock Lesnar live with that? Thank you, Byron.
Thank you.
Fight! Cody Rhodes has Lesnar where he wants him. Crossroads to Brock.
The delivery crossroads. Cody needed to use his left arm. Look.
Trying to fight through the broken arm. Lesnar stunned. Brock has no idea what hit him. Cody Rhodes again. Putting Lesnar in position for a second crossroads.
I cannot believe Cody's doing this again.
What a tolerance for pain this man has.
That's one of the toughest sons of guns to ever step in a ring.
Cody going for the trifecta, perhaps. And Brock, Kimura, Kimura, Kimura. Brock with a Kimura. Trying to make it to the rope, but you got to move that massive man. Cody is almost there. Cody's almost to the bottom rope. But Cody, not quite anything there. You got to be kidding me.
Cody, talk to me.
Cody made it to the rope to force the break, but
there was a look of disbelief on Lesnar's face.
There's nothing left. I mean, there can't be anything left in Cody Rhodes.
Oh, no.
And Cody, another crossroads.
Ow!
Rhodes for the win. Oh, my goodness, Lesnar kicked it too.
I lost my match against Brock Lesnar. My contemporaries, they told me that I was foolish to fight Brock Lesnar with one hand, that I was crazy to not tap out, but there's a reason why I didn't tap out. It's not because it didn't hurt. It was excruciating, career flash before your eyes type pain. I did not tap out because that's not the man that I want to be. Years ago, sure, I probably would have tapped out. Thought about my career, lived to fight another day. I have experienced enough highs and lows at this to know that some days, they just don't come. Sometimes the second chances don't present themselves. There was a wildly popular WWE superstar who used to stand in this ring, and he said, "Never give up." Never give up hurts like hell when you're locked in a Kimura for 3+ minutes. But nonetheless, Brock Lesnar, I have a question for you. And I've got to look into this camera to ask that question because you're not here tonight. I'm assuming you have taken your annual vacation. Brock Lesnar, are you satisfied with this being done? You have a victory over me. I have a victory over you. The game is 1-1. Are you satisfied? I hope you're not, because consider this an open challenge to you, Brock Lesnar. Hopefully you have social media, cable, a landline, something there in Saskatchewan or Yellowstone or wherever the hell it is that you roam. I'll post my whole schedule, every detail of it sometime this week, everywhere that I'll be this month, whether it's Wilkes-Barre, whether it's Wichita, whether it's Cleveland, whether it's Savannah, whether it's Newcastle. If I am standing in a ring, I am standing there ready to fight you, Brock Lesnar. And if you don't accept my challenge, Brock Lesnar, we can go ahead and add one more thing to that list. Brock Lesnar is afraid of what cannot be broken. Brock Lesnar is afraid of Cody Rhodes. So,
no.
The Beast is here!
And Rhodes isn't hanging around!
Cody Rhodes has been asking for this!
Oh my God!
Begging for this! Rhodes wants Lesnar! Well, Cody, you got him!
Cody issued an open challenge to Brock Lesnar. That's over a month ago. We have not seen Brock Lesnar since.
Well, Lesnar calls his own shots and operates on his own schedule. But Lesnar and Rhodes have come face to face, and the fists are flying.
Seth Rollins gets out of the ring.
But Cody Rhodes not backing down. Maybe he should have.
Rhodes now off the ropes. Oh!
Cody Cutter!
Can you believe it?
Beast! Cody Rhodes just stood down Brock Lesnar. Lesnar brought the fight to Rhodes, and Brock's the one in retreat. Wow! No one saw this coming tonight.
Yeah, adrenaline is in the soul. That's for sure. No more cast on the arm as Cody Rhodes stands tall against Brock Lesnar for now.
This is far, far from over.
Cody, earlier tonight, you got into it with Brock Lesnar out here. Do you care to comment on that?
Tonight is Jackie's first night on Monday Night Raw. I think everybody, can we say hi, Jackie?
Hi, Jackie!
There we go, Jackie. I think you will come to find out I am a man of my word. I said after Night of Champions that I would be waiting on Brock Lesnar. And tonight the Beast reared his head and I decided to speak his language, and the translation is simple. Welcome back, Brock. We are not done yet. Brock Lesnar broke my arm. I busted his face. There's no way that we can continue to coexist on Monday Night Raw. I want another shot at Brock Lesnar. I'll fight Brock Lesnar any night. I'll fight Brock Lesnar every night. Thank you very much.
The American Nightmare standing by his word. Cody still has unfinished business with the Beast Incarnate.
Everybody has a Brock Lesnar. Everybody, you name it. Fear of heights, Brock Lesnar. Crippling anxiety, Brock Lesnar. Student debt, Brock Lesnar. Your terrible boss, Brock Lesnar. I watched a woman in the Georgia Marathon 10 feet away from the finish line. Took a wrong turn, Brock Lesnar. We all have a Brock Lesnar. That thing that is impeding us from the most important step we can take. Albeit my Brock Lesnar, 6'3", 285 pounds, a walking billboard for Darwinism and natural selection. But what's that quote, right? Some men see the things the way they are and they say why, and other, Others dream things they've never seen and say, why not? I want to be the latter because what I dream is a rubber match with Brock Lesnar at SummerSlam. Brock Lesnar, nothing would make me happier than next week if you came to this ring, if you shook my hand, if you knew that this wasn't personal, if you honored me by being my opponent at SummerSlam, and even if you don't shake my hand, we're gonna play the same game. I'm gonna pop you in the side of the ear, I'm gonna hit you with chairs, I'm gonna pick up steps, I'm gonna finish the chapter that you started for no damn reason. The reason is simple. Why would anyone want another match with Brock Lesnar? Why do I have to have another match with Brock Lesnar? It's because what comes from that fight, what emerges from that cloud of dust is simple. That guy is next in line, and the prince doesn't want to be the prince forever. I will be next in line.
Cody's ready to go.
Rhodes is looking for Lesnar.
Of course it's Lesnar.
Brock is here, and Cody Rhodes just walked into the beast trap.
This predator. Insatiable need to hunt. Caught his prey.
Have attempted the same thing as Cody Rhodes. They have called out the beast. They have incited Brock Lesnar, and this is how it always turns out, with Lesnar standing tall over a broken challenger.
No. Cody's mother watching.
But we know Brock Lesnar does not fight fair.
Cody's arm could be broken all over again.
My mother, Michelle Runnels, she wasn't impressed. You gotta remember, this is the same lady who watched Terry Funk throw fireballs at my dad's face. The same lady who down the street in Ybor City was drinking with Gordon Solie at the Columbia. If anything, Brock Lesnar knew. My mother, she knew what I'm about to tell you, and that's, Brock, you made a mistake. And the mistake wasn't beating me up in front of my loved ones, taunting me in front of my family. The mistake was you left me breathing. So now, Brock Lesnar, I don't want to go to SummerSlam just to win the rubber match. I want to go to SummerSlam to embarrass you, Brock Lesnar. And I know there's a whole bunch of people backstage freaking out because I just said I'm going to embarrass Brock Lesnar. Oh, here he is. Cody's poking the bear. He's poking the bear. I am not poking the bear. I'm slapping the bear across the face and saying, come and get it. Brock Lesnar, I don't want to just beat you at SummerSlam because of the positive ramifications it would have on my career and my livelihood. I don't want to just beat you at SummerSlam because you made it personal when you broke my arm. I want to beat you at SummerSlam because it's what you deserve. And when I'm old and I'm gray and I'm sitting back smoking a Fuente 858 and I look at the chapter that says Brock Lesnar, I will know it wasn't pretty, but I pinned the final paragraph to that chapter at SummerSlam, Brock. I end this.
From the Beast.